the test on paper or on
No, these are just feelings.
Inflammation.
The test on paper or on
something that we need to know.
Here we go. Inflammation. Okay, so this is a fill-in. You're going to write right at the bottom, fill-ins. These are the fill-ins that I see. Inflammation is itis. Itis, inflammation. Mm-hmm. Inflammation can be anywhere in the body. Okay, if someone has an inflamed pancreas, what is it that they have?
Pancreatitis.
Pancreatitis. If someone has an inflamed heart, what is it called?
Carditis.
Carditis. If someone has inflamed
Bronchitis.
Bronchitis. If someone has an inflamed arthritis. A joint.
Arthritis.
If someone has an inflamed, what else? Tonsil.
Tonsillitis.
If someone has an inflamed bladder.
Bladderitis. No, I'm just playing.
Bladderitis.
I was just joking.
You have to know the word part for bladder.
I knew that. I forgot.
Starts with a C.
Cystitis.
Very good.
Somebody to know that for the test?
Cystitis? No, you just need to know what itis is.
Oh.
Cysto.
Okay, I'm making a point that itis can be anywhere. Okay, you have to know how to spell the word inflammation. Okay, next word. Blank are the smallest living units of body.
Cells.
Of the body.
Cells.
You have to know how to spell cells.
S-E-L-L. S.
What'd you say?
S-E-L-L.
Can you say it again?
Cells. The smallest living units of body organization.
The cells, organs.
Cells.
Cells, tissue, organs.
Okay, so that's why they had you doing the cell. You had to do the little cytoplasm, just a few things. Nucleus, cytoplasm. You just need to know that it's the cells that are the smallest living units of the body. Then it turns into tissue.
Tissues.
Remember?
Then organs.
Okay, and then once it gets to organs, then after organs is the systems. So the systems is what you need to know how to spell, the one that it stands for bones, joints, and muscle.
Musculoskeletal
system.
M-U-S-C-U-L-O-T-E-K-E-T-E-L. M-U-S-T-U.
Here's a nice big one. Musculoskeletal system. They're going to already have system there. Bones, joints, and muscles are all part of the musculoskeletal system. The hormone blank is responsible for producing male secondary sex characteristics.
Androgen.
Not the androgen. Oh, not, that's only for RMA. Testosterone. Don't be filling out androgen. Testosterone. Secondary characteristics has to do with the facial hair, bone growth, all the second stuff. So it's testosterone.
Oh, secondary. Here you go.
Okay. So the hormone testosterone, male secondary sex characteristics. Okay, next one. This has to do with the skin. What is that top layer called?
Epidermis.
Epidermis, but you're going to see stratum something. Stratum corneum. It's the horny outer layer of the skin.
Stratum corneum.
So it's the same thing as epidermis.
It's the same thing. As the epidermis, it's the outer layer of the skin. Yes. And you're going to see the top layer of the epidermis, talking about the epidermis, the top layer of it is called stratum corneum. You need to know how to spell corneum. You're already going to see the stratum there. Corneum.
So you're going to take points off if we don't spell it correctly?
I don't take it off if the corporate does. You'll miss 2 points.
Oh, I need that. I need my 2 points.
How to spell these? Corneum. Best way to do it is to start writing this 20 times. Stuff I'm saying, fill in, write it 20 times. You'll get it.
Inflammation.
Hopefully. You might have to do 50. Stratum corneum. Okay. Next is the heart has how many chambers?
Four.
Four, and it has how many valves?
Four.
Four.
Good. Write down the number four. Okay, this has to do with direction. Medial, distal, proximal. You guys remember these? Medial, distal, proximal? Okay. Do you see medial in here? Okay. Alright. So his hand is what to the shoulder?
Superior?
No.
His hand is...
When you're dealing with extremities, it's going to be proximal or distal. So the hand is what to the shoulder?
Distal.
It's away. So everything is away from the midline, unless you're talking about medial, which is in the middle. Okay? So distal, when you're saying from the shoulder, distal. Your finger is what from your wrist?
Distal.
Your shoulder is what from your hand?
Distal.
Proximal.
Closer. Okay. Closer. So proximal means closer to the body, distal means away, distance, away. Okay, so you need to know the nose or the heart is what to the ears?
Hold on, say that again.
The nose and the heart is what to the ears?
Medial.
So know how to spell medial, M-E-D-I-A-L, medial. So if they're talking about something in the middle, okay, you got groin, you got heart, you got neck, and you have nose, eyes, from the ears, from the shoulders. It's medial. Medial. It's to do with directions. Doctors use that in physical therapy usually, or orthopedic. Okay? Getting the rest of them. Urine is produced by the kidneys, transported to the bladder by the, talking about the kidneys, so.
Oh, the
urethra. Urethra. Urethra or ureter?
Ter.
Ter. Ter, ter, ter. It's ter, not thra. The urine is produced by the kidneys. Whenever kidneys, that means it's higher. Whenever it's higher, it's the ureters. So urine is produced by the kidneys and transported to the bladder by the ureters. Make sure you have that S at the end. You miss a stupid 2 points. Ureters. Okay. Another. Oh, here we go. What is the word that is the process by which your body converts nutrients into fuel?
What'd you say?
The process by which your body converts nutrients into fuel, and it's the sum for all chemical reactions in your body. So it has to do with you having a fast something or a slow something.
Metabolism.
Know how to spell it. Look up the definition. This was in your mod one, nutrition part. It's actually in your, when you watch, there's a video on metabolism. There's a video talking about nutrition and metabolism. Can't find it, look it up and look at up a, should be inside your medical terms. If not, you could look it up, what it is. Process by which your body converts nutrients into fuel. So if someone has a fast metabolism, that's when you eat, your body's like working super fast to burn it off. If you have a slow metabolism, it's gonna digest, everything's gonna be really slow because you like to eat late at night. And you don't like to move around, you want to lay on the couch, watch your favorite movie, use the remote, never get up. Your metabolism will slow down that way. And as you get older, it just slows down more and more and more. Your butt drops. Okay. Next. Looking up all these fillings. I think that's the last filling. What's the normal temperature?
98.6.
Okay, good. Oh, this is the last. Here we go. In the term arthrosis, arthro means what?
Joint.
Joint. Osis means what?
Condition, abnormal condition.
Condition of. That's it. Condition of.
Condition of?
Arthro.
I thought it meant abnormal condition.
Well, you're going to have other questions. Those are the fill-ins.
Oh.
Arthro is joint.
Arthro is joint. Osis suffix that means condition of. Okay, you guys are in my second one. How many of you guys get test anxiety?
Me.
Raise your hand. You just see the number. Okay, don't be shy. I used to as well. Until I gave the test.
I get so nervous.
Okay, so just so you know, the test is going to be looking, it's not going to give you the answers right now, but the test is going to be, some of them are going to be multiple choice. Okay, you're going to have a question. The brain and the spinal cord are the two structures of the central or peripheral?
Central.
Central is the side. Central. Your first form with your brain and spinal cord, that's in the middle. So it's the central. Okay?
The
and let me show you what a fill-in looks like. The top layer of the epidermis is the stratum.
Corneum.
So you'll be filling out corneum. Okay, so C-O-R-N-E-U-M. Okay, which of these is an accessory organ of the digestive?
Gallbladder,
because these are all primary. Stomach, small intestines, rectum. You guys did those, and then accessories are the side stuff. The liver, the gallbladder, salivary glands, pancreas, those are accessories. That means the side stuff. Normal body temperature is? And then I'm going to do this last one, last two right here. Which of these structures is not part of the upper respiratory tract? The bronchi. In the book, it says something different. You must know this because I'm telling you it. Bronchi is down lower, okay? The upper is the nasal and the throat. This is considered upper. The bronchi is lower. So that's in your PowerPoint that I gave you guys. So what is not part of the upper? The bronchi. That's down lower. And then bones, joints, and muscles are part of the, you're going to write it, the whole thing out in one word, musculoskeletal system. It already has system, so you're just going to write in musculoskeletal. Okay? So hopefully that alleviated your anxiety a little bit. Tuesday, if you want to go over more of this, we're going to go over some of this tomorrow. When are we here?
No.
Tomorrow night. So we'll go over some of this. I'll test you guys. We'll do more of a Jeopardy, doing different categories. Okay, and then we'll catch up on the rest of CS. So I'm opening up everything till Friday. I'm still working on opening this. I opened most of your labs already, some of you that missed it. I opened up some of your break it downs. Integumentary you should be done with. I'm not opening to integumentary in mod one, okay? You snooze, you lose on those two. Unless you have documentation that you missed something or you are out of country or something, I can extend something. Just let me know, and I'll open it just for you. Other than that, I'm opening for everybody. After integumentary system, lesson two and on, I'll open up till Friday, okay?
You said lesson two and everything. Well,
yeah, and right now,